Hello students, welcome to CET classes. In today's class, we'll be discussing the continuation of motion in a plane. So in the first part, we studied about 10 questions along with the synopsis. So today we are going to see the continuation of that part. So you can see the first problem here. A body moves along a circular track of radius 20 centimeter. It starts from one end of a diameter and moves along the circular track and reaches the other end of the diameter in 5 seconds. What is the angular speed of the body? Okay, if I want to draw here, the problem, whatever they given here, okay, if I want to consider that completely, so let me draw the circle. Okay, so I'm going to consider the point, that is t is equal to 0 seconds and t is equal to 5 seconds. So it is nothing but the diameter. The body starts from this point and ends at this particular point. So what is the angle of this? So theta is equal to 180 degree means pi. Okay, you know the formula, omega is equal to theta by t. So omega is nothing but angular speed, theta is nothing but angular displacement. So now theta is 5. What is the time? It is 5. So 5 pi by 5 radian per second will be your answer. So option 4. Okay, I hope you are clear with that. Okay, see with the next problem, a stone tied to the end of 20 centimeter long string is swirled in a horizontal circle. In a horizontal circle, if the centripetal acceleration is 9.8 meter per second square, its speed is in radian per second. You have to calculate. Okay, you know the acceleration is AC, that is nothing but centripetal acceleration is AC omega square R. Okay, but I want to find omega, right? Okay, omega is equal to root of AC divided by R. Can I write like that, right? Okay, so root of AC in this quote is 9.8 divided by 20 centimeter and there and the meter convert 0.2. So is equal to root of 98 into 10 divided by 98 to the power 10, 2 into 10 to the power minus 1. So, it will cancel. 98 by 2 is 49. So, root of 49 is 7. So, answer is option 2. I hope you are clear with that. Okay. So, the next problem is, so you can see the next problem. Two particles of masses M1 and M2 are moving in concentric orbits of radii R and R such that their periods are same. So their time period are same. Then the ratio between their centripetal acceleration is, you know the formula, AC is equal to omega square r. So they're telling that time period is constant, same. So I can say AC is directly proportional to r, right? So from this I can write AC1 divided by AC2 is equal to r1 divided by r2. What is your r1? It is capital letter R. R2 is small letter r. Okay, now the ratio will be capital letter R by small letter r. Option C. I hope you are clear. Good. See the next problem. A particle in uniform circular motion, the acceleration A at a point P on the circle of the radius is, I'll draw the circle here. Okay, so you can say that this is nothing but your y-axis. This is your x-axis. So the point is somewhere here. So I'm going to take P, R, comma, theta. So what about the acceleration? It will be moving towards the center. I can say at this particular point, it will be split into two components. It will be split into two components. If this is the theta, then this is also theta, since it is alternate angles, right? So that this component is nothing but AC. AC cos theta. This is nothing but AC sine theta. Now I can take it as, since they have given it as uniform circular motion, I can say the speed is constant. So not the velocity, speed is constant. Okay. In that case, I can write vector A is nothing but, you can see this AX cos theta is moving in the opposite direction of x axis. So it is minus AC cos theta I cap. Minus, again, you can see the sine component is moving in downward. Again, it is opposite. So minus AC sine theta j cap. So you know that AC is nothing but velocity by radius. Okay, so from I can write vector A is equal to minus v squared by r cos theta I cap minus v squared divided by r sine squared theta j cap. So answer will be option A. That is option one. I hope you are clear with this, right? So I'll repeat once again. What I've done, I've taken this complete component. So the object is at one particular point P. So P is equal to R, comma, theta. So it, at this particular point, that acceleration component will be split into two. Okay, one is A cos theta and A sine theta. We have the formula. We have to sub vector A is equal to minus. Why? Because it's moving in the opposite direction of x axis. Again, the other sine component is also opposite to the y axis. So that's why it is negative sign. Okay, clear. Okay, the next is, it's very simple. The average acceleration vector, the average acceleration vector for a particle having a uniform circular motion, for a particle having uniform circular motion, they've taken, time is taken for a full cycle. Okay, so then we can say the average acceleration vector will be null vector. Why? Since in one complete round, the displacement vector will be zero, right? Which implies that average velocity is also zero, which further implies that average acceleration also will be zero. So finally, for a particle having uniform circular motion, so I can say the vector will be null vector. So option two. Okay. So next, the range of a projectile is R. The range of projectile is R when the angle of projection is 30 degree. When the angle of projection is 30 degree, then the value of other angle of projection for the same range is, okay? So they have told that range is same, okay? So you have the condition, you have to remember the same range of projectile, okay? Range of projectile is same for theta and 90 minus theta. So please remember this. Why? Because the condition, the range, right? The range of projectile is same. Okay, same range. Anta kottiradinda theta is kottidare 30 degree. So 90 minus 30 is to, it is 60 degree. So option A. One, that is option one. Clear aita? So new condition in aapka itkonbeko. Range bandi, if range is same for theta and 90 minus theta. Clear aita? Okay. Okay, the next problem. An aeroplane is flying with a uniform speed of 100 kilometer. You observe madi along the circumference of the circle. Okay, observe here. Along the circumference of the circle, andre, you consider the circle. Okay, circumference andre illi alva. Okay, so the velocity will be always tangential, right? So it is v1. It is v2. Velocity will be tangential. Clear? Okay. So the change in velocity in half the revolution will be, so delta v is equal to delta 1 minus delta, sorry, delta v is equal to v1 minus v2. And the change in velocity is given as v1 minus v2. Okay, v1 minus v2 kottiradinda, you can say at one particular time it is 100. So since the velocity is opposite, I can write it as it is 100 minus of minus 100. Why? Because e velocity, you know, opposite direction agiradinda. So it is 200. Kilometer per hour. So option two. Clear? Okay. The next is the two projectiles A and B of same mass are thrown. Same mass are thrown with same velocity. With same velocity. With angle 60 degree and 30 degree respectively with horizontal. Okay. So you have RA by RB, the range at A divided by range at B. Okay, you have the formula U square sine 2 theta by G whole divided by U square sine 2 theta dash by g. So g get cancelled, u square get cancelled. So sine of 2 into, what is theta in first case? 60 degree. The second case, sine is equal to 2 into 30 degree. Okay, then it will be sine of 120 degree divided by sine of 60 degree. So sine 120 will be root 3 by 2. Sine 60 is also root 3 by 2. So one. So I can say RA is equal to RB. Option 2. Artha agideyala? Doubt enilla. Okay. Next, a particle is projected with the velocity 100 meter per second at 30 degrees, the time of flight. So time of flight formula node. So time of flight is equal to 2u sine theta, 2u sine theta divided by g. So 2 into 100 into sine of 30, sine 30 divided by 10. So 10 cancel. So 2 into 10 into 1 by 2, sine 30 is. So 2 and 2 get cancelled. The answer will be 10 seconds. So option 2. You are clear, right? Okay, next. The height y and the distance x along the horizontal plane of a projectile on a certain planet. So we are not going to consider the atmosphere. Are given. So with no surrounding atmosphere, you don't have any atmosphere there. Okay. Are given by y is equal to, are given by y is equal to 80 minus 5t. Correct. 80 minus 5t meter. And x is equal to 60 meter. 6t meter. Where t is in seconds. And velocity with which the projectile is projected is. Okay. You are going to start comparing this with. Now you see. So you can say y is equal to. It's nothing but y component. It is u sine theta. Why? Because the object is moving upward. So u sine theta t. Minus ut plus half at square and gt square. So you are going to say this is equivalent to 8t minus 5t square. Next, x is equal to u cos theta into t. This is nothing but 60. So you can say u sine theta is equal to 8, u cos theta is equal to 6. Okay. Now, u is equal to square root of u x andre, you have u x square plus u y square. So u x square andre no. U cos theta whole square plus u sine theta the whole square. It comes under the root. So u cos square under 6 square plus 8 square. So 6, 6 to 36. So 36 plus 64. 36 plus 64 root is root of 100. The answer will be 10 meter per second. So option 2. I hope you are clear with this, right? Okay. So next problem. A projectile is projected at 10 meter per second by making an angle 60 degree. After some time, its velocity makes an angle of 30 degree to the horizontal. Okay, here you see, since given the problem, the horizontal component of the velocity remains constant, correct? Since the horizontal component of the velocity remains constant, you can write that as u cos 60 is equal to v cos 30. So u they given as 10. So cos 60 is 1/2 is equal to v cos 30 is 3/2. So 2 and 2 get cancelled. So v is equal to 10/√3 meter per second. So 10/√3. It is option 1. Artha aitalvendrappa? Okay. So allele conditions kana neat aagi nodkolli ashta. Okay, next problem nodi. A point P moves in counter clockwise direction on a circular path as shown in figure. The movement of P is such that it sweeps out the length S is equal to T cube plus 5, where S is in meter and T is in second. The radius of the path is 20 meter. The acceleration of P when T is 2 seconds. Okay, so acceleration can derive. Okay, Gabani, point wise, one by one we'll see. The thing they are given, ill in the solve matta idene, S is equal to T cube plus 5. So V is nothing but ds by dt. So when you differentiate, 3t square. V. Again, A is equal to dv by dt. So A is equal to 60. Now, at t is equal to 2 seconds, velocity will be 12 meter per second. Just I'm substituting the t value. What about acceleration is? Again, 12 meter per second after t is equal to 2 seconds. Okay, right. So now, why? Because when you see at this particular point P, you can say the total acceleration is given as root of acceleration tangential acceleration plus centripetal acceleration. So this is nothing but your tangential acceleration, normal. So centripetal andre AC is equal to V square divided by R. V square divided by R. What is your V? It is 12. So 12 whole square andre 144 divided by 20. 144 divided by 20. So if you solve approximately, it will be 7.2 barat. Okay, if you substitute that in this equation, so 80 squared, sorry. So root of 80 square is 12 whole square under 4144 plus 7.2 the whole square marvek. So if you do 7.2 the whole square madre, so solve madiyenge 7.2 into 7.2 is 195. So root of 195 ಅಂತ ತಗೊಂಡ್ರೆ ಅಪ್ರಾಕ್ಸಿಮೇಟ್ಲಿ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು 14 ಬಂದ್ಬಿಡುತ್ತೆ, 14 ಮೀಟರ್ ಪರ್ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್. ಸೊ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ 4. ಸೊ ಆಕ್ಚುಲಿ ಅದು ಎಕ್ಸಾಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗಿ ಮಾಡಿದಾಗ 13.96 ಬರುತ್ತೆ, ಅಂತ ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗಿ ಸಾಲ್ವ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ. ಸೊ ಅಪ್ರಾಕ್ಸಿಮೇಟ್ ಆಗಿ 14 ಅಂತ ತಗೊಂತೀನಿ. ಅರ್ಥ ಆಯ್ತಾ? ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್. ಎ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ ಇಸ್ ಪ್ರೊಜೆಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ಅಟ್ 60 degrees ಟು ದ ಹಾರಿಜಾಂಟಲ್ ವಿತ್ ಎ ಕೈನೆಟಿಕ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಕೆ. ದ ಕೈನೆಟಿಕ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಅಂತ ಹೈಯೆಸ್ಟ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಕೇಳಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಸೊ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ನಾಪ್ಕ ಇಟ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ, ಇನಿಷಿಯಲ್ ಅಂತ ತಗೊಂಡ್ರೆ, ಓಕೆ ಇನಿಷಿಯಲ್ ಆಗಿ ತಗೊಂಡ್ರೆ, ಸೊ ಕೈನೆಟಿಕ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಹಾಫ್ ಎಂ ಯು ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್. ಈಗ ಕೈನೆಟಿಕ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಅಂತ ಹೈಯೆಸ್ಟ್ ಅಂದರೆ ಕೆ ಡ್ಯಾಶ್, ಕೆ ಡ್ಯಾಶ್ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್, ಕೆ ಡ್ಯಾಶ್ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಹಾಫ್ ಎಂ ವಿ ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್. ಸೊ ಈಗ ಇನ್ ಟರ್ಮ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಪ್ರೊಜೆಕ್ಟೈಲ್ ಅಂದರೆ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಮೂವಿಂಗ್ ವರ್ಟಿಕಲಿ ಅಪ್ವರ್ಡ್, ರೈಟ್? ಸೊ ಹಾಗೇನಾಯ್ತು, ಹಾಫ್ ಎಂ ಯು ಕಾಸ್ 60 ದ ಹೋಲ್ ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್. ಸೊ ಹಾಗೇನಾಯ್ತು, ಹಾಫ್ ಎಂ ಯು ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್ ಕಾಸ್ 60 ಇಸ್ 1/2, 1/2 ದ ಹೋಲ್ ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್ ಇಸ್ 1/4, ಬಟ್ ಹಾಫ್ ಎಂ ಯು ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್ ಕೆ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್, ರೈಟ್? ಕೆ ಡ್ಯಾಶ್ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಕೆ ಬೈ 4. ಸೊ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ 3. ಅರ್ಥ ಆಯ್ತಾ? ಓಕೆ, ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ನೋಡಿ. ಎ ಬಾಯ್ ಪ್ಲೇಯಿಂಗ್ ಆನ್ ದ ರೂಫ್ ಆಫ್ ಎ 10 meters ಹೈ ಥ್ರೋಸ್ ಎ ಬಾಲ್ ವಿತ್ ಎ ಸ್ಪೀಡ್ ಆಫ್ 10 meters ಪರ್ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಅಟ್ ಅನ್ ಆಂಗಲ್ ಆಫ್ 30 degrees ವಿತ್ ದ ಹಾರಿಜಾಂಟಲ್. ಹೌ ಫಾರ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದ ಥ್ರೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ದ ಬಾಲ್ ಬಿ ಅಟ್ ದ ಹೈಟ್ ಆಫ್ 10 meters ಫ್ರಮ್ ದ ಗ್ರೌಂಡ್. ಸೊ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಫೈಂಡ್ ದ ರೇಂಜ್. ಯು ನೋ ದ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಫಾರ್ಮುಲಾ. ಸೊ ಆರ್ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಯು ಸ್ಕ್ವಯರ್ ಸೈನ್ 2θ ಡಿವೈಡೆಡ್ ಬೈ ಜಿ. ಸೊ 10² ಸೈನ್ ಆಫ್ 2 × 30 ಇಸ್ 60 ಹೋಲ್ ಡಿವೈಡೆಡ್ ಬೈ 10. ಸೊ 10² ಕ್ಯಾನ್ಸಲ್. ಸೊ ಸೈನ್ 60 ಇಸ್ √3/2. ಸೊ 1s are 5s are. ಸೊ 5√3. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಅದನ್ನ ಕನ್ವರ್ಷನ್ ಮಾಡೋದಾದ್ರೆ ನಾನು ಹೇಳಿದ್ದೇನೆ, ಈ √3 ನ ನಿಯರರ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ತಗೊಂಡು ಅದನ್ನ ಸಾಲ್ವ್ ಮಾಡಿ. ಓಕೆ, ಅವಾಗ ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಗೆಟಿಂಗ್ 5 × √3 ಅಂದ್ರೆ 1.7 ಸಮ್ ಚೇಂಜ್ ಬರುತ್ತೆ. So 1.8 anta tagondrunu the answer will be 9 barutte. But 9 nearer yavudu 8.66. Arthaita? Next, which of the following statement is false for the particle moving in circle with a constant axial speed? The velocity vector is tangent to the circle. Velocity vector will be tangent. The acceleration vector is tangent to the circle. No. The acceleration vector points to the center of the circle. Yes. The velocity and the acceleration vectors are perpendicular to each other. Yes. The false will be option 2. The acceleration vector is tangent to the circle. It is not tangent to the circle. Okay. I hope you are clear with this. Okay. The last problem. A boat crosses a river from port A to port B, which are just on the opposite side. The speed of water is VW. The speed of water is VW and that of boat is VB, related to still water. Assume VB is 2 times the VW. The velocity of boat is 2 times the velocity of water. What is the time taken by the boat if it has crossed the river directly on AB line? I'll draw the figure. So this is the velocity, this is A and B. So the overall distance will be capital letter D. So if then this direction, I can say it is VW. There's some angle, this is VB. VB, the boat. Okay. So I'm going to apply the Pythagoras theorem. This is nothing but VB, right? This is your VW, this distance. So I can say VB square is equal to V squared plus VW squared. So I want V. So V is equal to root of VB square minus VW square. Okay, since VB is equal to 2VW, so the V is equal to root of 4VW square minus VW square. But, the options what they've given, the options, it is in terms of VB, right? So VB and the N Madbeko. It should be in terms of VB only, right? Okay. So Agnanin Bari Bodo. VW is equal to VB by 2 agate. VW is equal to VB by 2. Vagal substitute markol il solve martini. V is equal to root of VB square minus VW badlo VB square divided by 4. So final solve martaga 3VB square divided by 4 under the root. So finally I can write it as root 3 by 2 VB. Root 3 by 2 into VB. Okay, the time candidate ke liye hai. What is the time? So t is equal to AB divided by velocity. What is your AB? What is your AB? AB is nothing but D, right? Okay, so capital letter D divided by V is root 3 by 2 into VB. So finally, I can write it as 2D divided by root 3 VB. So it is finally the option A. 2D by VB into root 3. VB into root 3. Okay. So clear right answer. Innocently repeat Martini problem. A boat crosses a river from port A to port B, which are just on the opposite side. The speed of the boat is VW, and that of boat is the speed of the water is VW, and that of boat is VB relative to still water. And condition kottidare iga illi nodi object it is moving from A to B. Distance velocity of water, this is velocity of boat. So according to the Pythagoras theorem I've written, finally the answer will be 2D divided by root T. So first velocity kandiditira. After the velocity, you are going to find the time. Okay. I hope you are clear with this particular chapter. So we'll meet in the next class with the new topic. So thank you all. Have a great day.